So for those of you who don't know, yes, I am a voice actor, but I don't really voice act as often as I'd like to because getting roles kind of sucks sometimes. And this is one of those times. So this was about like, what, 3 years ago maybe? Maybe even 4 years ago, I'm not sure. But basically what happened was that my friend introduced me to this guy who wanted to make his own visual novel. Like, this is one of my closest friends. My friend is like really good voice actor as well. He's gotten so many projects. He's been in a game before. So like, he really wanted to be like, bro, we should both be in this. And his character was a classic like Prince Charming kind of like character who's really nice. And like, yeah, he's pretty much a prince. And as he was telling me about his character, I was like, all right, say no more. I want to be a cool like character that like people would thirst over. I'm not even joking. That's why I checked out the project. So yeah, he sent me the project. The first red flag was that a lot of the characters were already cast. At least in my opinion, it is very disrespectful to do because you have a deadline for a reason. The deadline is there that way you can figure out who is better for which character, and that way you can cast everyone accordingly and appropriately. When you cast before the deadline, that shows that you are just gonna cast the first person who you think is good enough, rather than waiting to see who else will audition and, you know, picking the better one out of everyone who auditioned. You know, you're just in a hurry and the performance really doesn't matter that much. At least in my opinion, obviously, everyone has their own opinions, but this is how I see it. I saw that red flag, but either way, I was like, okay, let me see what characters are available. There was three. Three out of like the eight. You know, which is not bad, but at least the characters were cool that were left. The three remaining characters only had about like five auditions each, I believe. One of them really like captured my interest, and that was a Yandere type of character. Now, I've never voiced a Yandere before, but I've always wanted to. It was honestly the clear choice, because there was like this other character that was like the shy little brother type of character, and there was another one that was kind of like the super like harsh, like super cool, you know, hard to love kind of character, you know, like the cool jocks who are like, oh, I'm too cool for school kind of characters. My voice type only really fit one of those, which was like the shy little brother, because my voice is kind of high and I can kind of be a little bitch boy. But I really wanted to try being a Yandere. I've been a villain once before, and I've always wanted to try again because that one performance I was a villain on, that project never saw the light of day, you know, that we never saw that episode, and I'm really upset about that. So I've been wanting to do some like crazy laughters and like some cool like, like some crazy like, you know what I mean? Like, I want to be crazy really, because like at least to me, it seems like so much fun to do, and I really want to voice villains, I really want to voice these kind of characters, so yeah, I auditioned, and these lines were interesting to say the least. If I remember correctly, one of the lines were something about like wanting to cut their throat, but then like someone enters the room and then like they basically like, oh, what are you doing here? Like, you know, all shy. And it's like, I remember just reading that and I was like, is this right? Is this what Yanderes are about? I've seen a few Yandere animes, but this one was a little too cliche for my liking, but I mean, I had fun with it at least. Another line was, I believe, where it was basically just like, it was very graphic also. It was more sexual than it was like, you know, I'm gonna kill you. And the third line was just like typical like tone, like it was a normal tone, and they wanted kind of like a crazy laughter. And if I remember correctly, the way they wanted that line to sound was they sounded normal at first, but once they like realized who you were, they started going a little crazy and they started like imagining all the things they could do to you. Now, I was a bit uncomfortable. I was a bit uncomfortable with these lines, but overall I was like, okay, this is gonna be fun. Obviously he's meant to be a little cliche because of all of the, you know, with the first line literally being like, I'm gonna slit your throat, eh? So I harnessed my Yandere energy from all the Yandere animes I've seen. I had fun with it. I put on kind of a cliche voice. I had fun with the laughters. I love doing those crazy laughters with a passion. I've been practicing them for such a long time. And yeah, I auditioned, and immediately, like 5 minutes later, my buddy texts me being like, yo, he wants to message you. Bro, the owner wants to like talk to you. And I'm like, what? Already? I just sent it. So he puts me in a group DM with the person. And you know, at first everything is cool because he's like, bro, your voice is so cool. And I'm like, yeah, thanks. Like, bro, you nailed it. And I was like, oh, really? That's awesome. And then he starts giving me more lines to do, you know, as like a round two of like, okay, we need to see what you're fully capable of. And these lines were, you know how I said like I was a little uncomfortable doing the first set of lines? Yeah, these were way worse. Like, I'm not talking about like, oh, you know, like, no, I mean like actually like full on. Like, I then realized what I was getting myself into, which is basically that this character was, this character is not Yandere in the normal sense. Like, this character isn't like a, oh, I'm an obsessive person because I want the one I love. Like, no, this person is straight up like, I like blood and I like killing people. Like, that's legit their character. That is what they told me. This person said like, yeah, they like blood. They like blood a lot. And it's like, yeah, nope. Nope. But nonetheless, I was like, okay, there's one of these lines that I feel like I could probably do, because it's just, once again, I'm still in the mindset of like, this could be fun. So I do one of these lines, And he's like, he's just clapping. He's like, bro, I want you right now. And it's like, okay, in what way? What do you mean? He's like, yeah, you got it. You got the part. And I was like, oh, cool. Okay, sweet. So I then had a conversation with the owner one-on-one being like, yeah, so like, I'm not comfortable doing this. Can we tone this down? And thankfully they were very respectful about it. And they kind of knew themselves that they overplayed the yandere aspect a lot. But as they said, the whole reason why they did that was because they wanted someone who can go to that intense craziness. They wanted someone who can get to that level of craziness just so they can like have that measurement of like what they're capable of, which I guess makes sense, but also like, I mean, I guess. So yeah, he gives me a full script to read, and it's very much typical kind of visual novel lines where I'm just talking normally, and then it slowly gets a little bit more like, no, you should keep following me, or hey, you should keep like hanging out with me, you know. I'm not gonna lie, the writing was really good. I really liked the buildup of him becoming slowly more and more obsessive. So yeah, I do these lines, I turn them in, he really likes them, and then he kind of goes silent for a long time. And at first I was very confused because I messaged the person and be like, hey, when are the next round of lines? And because this person literally went full silence, like this person disappeared and vanished out of the earth or something like that. Like I have no clue where they went. So a few days go by, then a week goes by, then a month goes by, and then like 6 months go by. And then yeah, like 6 or 7 months later, they put me in a group chat and they message everyone who are also in the project of being like, hey, so sorry, I didn't like my last project. And I remember everyone being like, what? Excuse me? Wait, where have you been? And basically this person said like, hey, this project is getting scrapped. We're forming a new one. And I remember just everyone just like, being like, what? Excuse me? But we already did lines. And yeah, the owner was still like, yeah, but like, I didn't like it, so we're redoing everything. And this is gonna be a completely new project. Everyone's getting new roles, everyone's getting new characters, everything is new. And it was so funny because after that, everyone just kept leaving. Like, all these people who were in like the project just kept leaving. Cause like, I mean, honestly, I was so close to doing the same as soon as he said like, oh, everything's scrapped, I was like, okay, I'm leaving too at this point. But I wanted to stay because I was like, okay, what didn't you like about it? Because like, honestly, I liked my parts a lot. I thought it was really cool. And then, so I talked to them and, you know, I kind of understood what they're trying to say. And then they like, but yeah, thanks for staying. Here's your character. And the character he gives me, I've never been upset about a role I was given. But I think this was the most, I think this was it. I think this was the most I've ever been like disappointed. So he says like, yeah, I wanted to give you a character that really helped with your tone of voice. I really want to give a character that really like helped you. And I was like, okay, cool. So what's the character? And he's like, here's a stoner surfer dude. Yeah. And I'm just there like, excuse me? Like, what? He's like, yeah, no, I really think like a perfect, this is literally what he said. He's like, this is a perfect combination of character, a perfect love child of like Shaggy from Scooby-Doo and a surfer dude. And I'm just there like, what? He's like, yeah, no, this would really fit your voice this perfectly. And I'm like, no, I'm out of here. I'm done. It's so weird because I've never felt so insulted and confused at the same time. Because like, okay, so the reason why I was upset was because not only are you giving me a character that was completely the opposite of what I originally auditioned for, but also I don't even get a say. And not only that, but like, I'd have no experience in voicing like this kind of like dude bro kind of character. Like, I could try. I told him like, I'm willing to try, but like, I don't want to do this. And like, the owner was really like adamant about like wanting me to like voice a surfer dude. And at that point, I was like, okay, I'm out. I'm sorry, buddy. I'm out of here. But yeah, and then I haven't talked to the owner since, thankfully. I don't know if they're still doing other projects. I don't know what's going on, but yeah. But yeah, no, long story short, if other people like your project and you don't, I don't know what to tell you. like I understand like making something you're not proud of, but like if a lot of other people like it, I feel like you should at least like try to like finish some of it and at least have some of a final product, because other people put their hard work into it. Other people want to see that finished product, especially since they took their time to audition and to make lines for that. You know, like for example, I took time to audition. I did the round two of auditioning. I talked to that person privately and about what I was comfortable with, what I was not. I did lines. I did a ton of lines for that character, and then it was just all scrapped. And that sucks. That sucks a lot. But yeah, no, that was the one time I voiced the yandere. I hope to do more roles like that. Maybe, I don't know. Hey, this is Editing Akira. So currently it is about 4 a.m. And I've been working on this video literally all day. So I kind of wanted to challenge myself because I knew that I can get this video done in one day. But little did I know, it's actually hard to get a video done in one day. As soon as I woke up, I sat down, I recorded this video, and I started editing the video. And I took about 3 breaks, and this entire video took about 7 hours to edit fully. I started around like 2:30, 3 o'clock-ish, and by the time I knew it, it was already 9:30, and I was almost done with the video. I was almost done. I don't know how that happened. Like, literally 1 second later, I was like, oh wow, the sun's gone. So that was interesting. I did mention that my New Year's resolution was to try to upload every single day. I mean, it's possible. To be fair though, I spent a lot of time trying to figure out what to do and trying to find like the certain footage and the certain like images that I needed, so I don't think it really took like 12 hours. No, it didn't. It maybe took like maybe like a third of that time, maybe in a half of that time. I have no clue. But I hope you all enjoy it. And let me know what you all think in the comments below. Let me know what other things you want me to talk about in the future. I always read all my comments, so, and all of your suggestions really do help. So yeah, thank you very much. And I guess I have nothing more to say, so I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.